Hello, I'm Ben Bordissel, Business Development Manager for Moog's Commercial Slip Rings. I'm here to introduce you to our Ethernet products, some of the features, and a few of the questions I regularly hear from customers. To start, Moog has taken most of our standard commercial series and created versions wired specifically for Ethernet communication. We test 100% of our slip rings to cable or Ethernet parameters appropriate for that part using a fluke cable tester. This allows us to guarantee our parts will function just like standard Ethernet cable you might use if your application was not rotating. All of our designs use the same high-quality sliding contacts, so there is no change in life or reliability when moving to an Ethernet-configured part, nor are our standard environmental ratings impacted. The wide range of Ethernet options are highlighted in our Ethernet brochure. And I've got a sample of our products in front of me. You can see that our standard method of termination uses a male RJ45 connector, which we are all familiar with from your Ethernet cables in home or office. One key piece of information we need when determining the right slip ring for your application is whether you'll be running at 10 or 100 megabit data speeds, or if you're running at 1,000 megabits, also called gigabit Ethernet or gig-E. The slower speed only requires two twisted pairs in the Ethernet cable, whereas a gig-E cable requires four. Unlike most standard commercial cables, we are only going to populate the rings for the number of connectors you actually need. This will cut down on the cost and size of the part. You'll see on some of our data sheets, we list the Ethernet as 1000 base T or 2 by 100 base T. This indicates that the part is configured for 1000 base T, but you can manually split the cable into two 100 base T cables, or if requested during the quote process, we can do so when the part is built. Most of our standard product data sheets will list Ethernet as an available feature or option. In these cases, the Ethernet configuration needs to be requested when you contact us for a quote. The standard part must be properly configured to guarantee optimal performance. Products from our Ethernet section on the website will be pre-configured for Ethernet under their standard part numbers. You can also identify these parts through the heading on the data sheets. One of the more common concerns we see is whether power can be run through our slip rings with the Ethernet signal. Our parts are designed to function exactly in that manner. When laying out the internal circuits, Moog's standard design practices isolate any sensitive signal circuits from possibly noisy power circuits. In addition to the way the rings are positioned in the part, the power and signal leads are often routed out separate lead exits to isolate as much as possible. If you know you have a particularly noisy power supply, additional steps can be taken to add shields or other means of further isolation. It is a good design practice to replicate any shielding you may have in your static cable runs through the slip ring. These are just some of the basics when it comes to using Ethernet through slip rings. To dive a little deeper, like understanding the difference between UDP and TCP formats, see my blog on the Moog website. The Ethernet brochure also touches on many other protocols that can be supported using our Ethernet configuration. You can reach us through our website with any specific questions you may have or by calling 1-800-552-3014.